The Center for Neurobehavioral Research at Boys Town National Research Hospital focuses on improving methods for early intervention in the lives of children with behavioral and mental disorders. One disorder affecting a large number of adolescents is post-traumatic stress disorder.
One of the things about PTSD is that your ability to cope with other stuff because you're already coping with your trauma is much diminished.
PTSD can be challenging to treat as its biology is not fully understood.
That's where they're comparing emotion regulation.
Stuart White is hoping to change that.
Anybody that's ever been hungry knows that that impacts your mood, right? Like, I'm terrible to be around if I'm hungry. So we know your body plays a really big role in how you feel, how you think, how you react to situations. But those actual mechanisms that are linking your brain and your body, and particularly how those mechanisms function in mental illness, is not very well understood. It's not sufficiently well understood, certainly, for us to really have a grasp on all the different levers that we might be able to push on to help these kids.
Dr. White has received a 4-year grant from the National Institute of Mental Health to study the interaction between the neural and hormonal mechanisms implicated in children with PTSD. Current treatment strategies for pediatric PTSD do not consider the role of testosterone.
Testosterone has receptors in the brain, so when you have testosterone released in your body, that makes it into your brain, and we know that that changes what your brain does. But we don't really know how that well. We're still figuring out, and particularly in kids. The little work that's been done has been done almost exclusively in adults. So we have a couple of new ways of getting a testosterone response and really looking at it in kids.
Utilizing the hospital's functional MRI, Dr. White will be analyzing both healthy adolescent patients and those with PTSD. Both groups of youth will complete tasks in the fMRI designed to assess brain responses to threats in the environment and observe neural processes associated with emotion regulation. Each child will complete a series of tasks, which will either raise or not raise their testosterone level.
We're going to then take those numbers into account when we're looking at the two different brain scans.
Understanding the biological processes behind PTSD will be useful for cognitive behavioral therapies and different pharmacological treatments.
Eventually, the goal is to kind of give another set of tools so that clinicians have a way of using what the body's telling us to really make informed clinical decisions about what we shouldn't be doing, what isn't working.